One thing that like I see like as my role, I feel like everybody has like a role in whatever, like let's just like talk about like the financial like space, financial education space, right? So I see my role the same way I saw my role when I used to teach Sunday school, like as a teenager, preschool, as like 20, early 30s, and the budget needs to now that, you know, like I'm here to provide you with the financial fundamentals because I don't care how much money you make. If you don't have the fundamentals, you can be wiped out just like that. I've seen it.
Yes.
Wiped out. I'll give an example. I remember I was at speaking at this speaking engagement. This woman came up to me and said, "I don't know what I do. I don't know what I should do. I owe over $1 million." And I was like, "What?" And she had had cancer, and that was her medical bill when it was all said and done. So how you out earning that? You know what I mean? Like you out earn the
Yes.
cancer. So like those are the financial fundamentals of this. I actually call it financial wholeness, right? So these are the fundamentals. It's budgeting. People don't want to talk about like because it's not sexy like GameStop and options, blah, 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 right? Like, cause, and the caveat is this: sis is wealthy. I have multiple. My net worth is multiple seven figures. I'm not talking about like theoretically in stuff. I'm talking about cash. I'm talking about investments. I'm talking about real estate. Like, I have money. Just to preface it with that, because you know
Don't
people
play
hear
like
about
don't
the
play
wait,
nah,
wait,
like don't
don't
play
play with
yourself. Don't ever play yourself.
no, because
That she
I
speaks of it herself. Third person.
no
This
because no
is wealthy.
because
I'm gonna start
because
you.
sometimes people
Bro is
hear.
wealthy. Bro is wealthy. First and foremost,
Don't play yourself.
don't ever play yourself,
No,
please.
I share that because because when people hear the fundamentals, they're like, wah, wah, broke. No,
Yeah, just
there's
skip
nothing broke
over
here. Not only am I
it.
wealthy, I'm debt-free like a five-year-old. I don't owe nobody nothing, not even my businesses. Like I have
Debt
five
free
businesses,
mafia. Yes.
right? We made eight figures last year, just over 10 million. I'm not saying that to brag. I'm saying that to set the stage for, I'm talking about fundamentals from a place of you can grow wealth from a place of fundamentals and wealth that you can actually keep. So let's go over the 10 financial fundamentals. I like to call it financial wholeness. It's a holistic view of your finances. One, budgeting. Two, savings. Three, debt. You have to manage debt. You don't have to be
Yes.
debt free. You know, I know people like debt free, debt free. Guess who else is debt free? I told y'all, like, literally today is my niece's birthday, right? And she don't have no mortgage, no car, no nothing. And she's four. Happy birthday. Shout out to you, girl. But you're still broke. You know, because debt freedom doesn't equal, we mentioned that before, debt freedom does not equal wealth, right? So, three, debt, four, credit, right? Credit is a lever. I don't think people understand that. Like think about a door. A door is a lever. This small knob can twist a big door. That's what credit is able to do. It is this a small amount of money that's able to give you access to large amounts of money, right? This is what credit is. Five, learning to earn, increasing your income. I hope you're writing this down. Okay. You have to learn to earn, you know, like it's not just enough to budget and save. You're not going to budget and save your way to wealth. It's great foundational stuff, but you have to know how to bring money into your household. Six, investing for both retirement and wealth. I make the distinction because to me, investing for retirement is really investing in a way that will help you to maintain your current lifestyle. That's the bare minimum.
Minimum, yes.
Like, are we trying to eat cat food? What are we doing? No. You know, but investing for wealth is being able to increase your current lifestyle and leave money for your heirs. So I like to separate retirement and wealth. So that is six. Seven, insurance. It is super important. Health insurance, life insurance, disability insurance, right? Property and casualty insurance. Think of like home and auto. Are you insured? Insurance is a risk management tool. Insurance is there to protect you and your assets just in case you need it. Most people are underinsured. I know I was. Like, I thought I was good. I'm like, oh, I'm good out here in these streets. I sat down with a friend of mine who's a CFP and she's like, let me see your stuff. She was like, okay, everything's good, Tiffany, but you're insured like you're 20. I was like, I look 20. She's like, but you're not 20. Right? And so she was like, you need an umbrella policy. I was like, oh, how much is that going to cost me? Because sis is really the budgetista.
Talk about that. Can you talk about that? The
Yeah,
umbrella.
cover that, please.
Yes. And so the umbrella policy, it's like the low-key secret. I was like, okay. She said, let's start off. This was like maybe 2 years ago. Let's start off with, so you have your normal basic insurance. Like, you know, I have homeowners insurance. I've got car insurance, but I also have business insurance. And she's like, just in case those things are maxed out because something happens, someone falls and they sue you for more than this other insurance can cover. You have this umbrella policy, right? And so for me, an additional $1 million, which I was like, ooh, sounds pricey. It was $400 a year.
It's cheap.
I said, what? They don't tell you these things in these streets. Yes, an umbrella policy is just a great way to make sure. So then I increase it as my wealth increases. I increase that umbrella policy, and it like it's a lever too. A little bit of money gives you access to all this coverage. So 7, get good with insurance. 8, grow rich-ish, your net worth. Don't tell me how much you made, how much you keep, right? So that's cute that like, oh, I made $7 million last year. They won't tell you that they spent $8 million in marketing, yep. Right? Net worth is what you own minus what you owe. If you owe a whole lot, it doesn't matter if you own a whole lot, because at the end of the day, if all the people that you owe come a calling, you're broke, right? So maintaining a positive net worth, that's important. 9, picking your money team. Y'all are already doing it. Y'all listen to these fellows right here. You want to have financial professionals in your life. I believe in having an accountability partner because I think money is a team sport. But I also believe like you might look to an insurance broker, but you want to have people on your financial team. And last but not least, estate planning. You know, planning your legacy. It doesn't make sense to do all of this and not to pass on. That's the problem that we've had a hard time. I've known Black folks that have grown wealth. I've known brown people that have grown wealth, but sometimes the passing on is what we have a hard time with, the passing on of knowledge, the passing on of wealth, you know, from one generation to the next. That's your 10 components. Like, here's the thing about financial freedom, right? I'm not a big fan of that phrase. Here's why. Because you can be financially free and not be financially whole. You can have all the money, you could have all those things, but you could be missing, like, for example, Prince, financially free. We can all agree, man was wealthy. Was he financially whole? No, he didn't have an estate plan. Mm-hmm. So when Prince died, he used to give a lot of money to like music programs because he believed it saved them as a kid. Mm-hmm. So when he died, his closest relative was his sister. We don't know if she's big on music programs. Mm-hmm. You know, his money is going to do what she wants it to do. So I say that, not to say don't go after financial freedom, but I'll go for a holistic view of your money. And so literally that's why, you know, because the fellas are, hello. That's why I wrote Get Good With Money. 10 simple steps to becoming financially whole. It's available at getgoodwithmoney.com. Not for real. I see myself like as like the school teacher of personal finance. Like, I want you to get the fundamentals. So that way, no matter what you build on this financial like safe foundation, yo, like when this last, like the last recession, 2008, 2009, 2010 hit, yo, it rocked me to the core. I lost everything. I said, never again. This time when it hit, I made money. You know, like I made money. My business tripled because I said, I'm going to position myself to have such a strong foundation that when things happen, it's the difference between being a tree and being an electric pole. Some of y'all out here, not y'all, but some of y'all out here, so interested in being as big and tall and obvious as possible. Like, look at me, and you're this pole, this electric pole, and it looks dope because it looks so high, right? It flung up quickly, and you're laughing at the tree. Tree is going slow. You're like, ah, look at the tree. Then earthquake comes. That pole is this deep in the ground. Pole falls over. Tree got what? Roots, right? Yeah. And so that's what I'm wanting for you. I'm wanting for all of us to have like this deep financial foundation. So everything you're learning in EYL, everything you're learning in Market Mondays, these are things that you're building on top of your financial foundation so that house can stand. So you can gift that house to someone else.
My graduates from my school being Forbes, bag drop.
Bag drop.
A mic drop. Bag drop.
Bag drop.